done for. I'll put that call back in the pending.
Good.
It was one of the most brutal murders in county history, detectives told me. They hunted him all night, caught him early in the morning. When they told him he could see a lawyer, he said, no, I want to see a chaplain instead. So they called me back to the station. I had been up most of the night with this case. And they put me in a room alone with the suspect, separated by bars, thank God. No sooner do they close the door on us when he starts confessing. First-degree murder. Father, he says, I have sinned. I don't know why. I was drunk, I guess. What should I do? Well, what should I tell him to do? I opened my Bible and read from the Proverbs, whoever covers his sin shall not prosper, but whoever confesses and forsakes them shall have mercy. I told him about Jesus dying the death we all deserve and rising from the dead to heaven's sanctuary. And I said, he's your real priest. He's the only one that can forgive you of this sin. I explained how he could come boldly to God's throne of grace. And he did. He wanted to pray. He accepted Jesus right there with me. But something about it just didn't seem right. I believe in radical grace, but grace for this guy seemed way too radical, way too soon. He had blood on his hands, literally, on his fingernail cuticles. I thought I could see dried blood from his victim. But then I remembered that we're all sinners, so I'd better embrace this grace. Frank and Sue were out clubbing one Saturday night. I guess they had quite a bit to drink. When they came home, they started yelling at each other, really getting into each other's face. And then, right in the middle of the curse-out contest, Frank drops dead. And Sue screams, God! Oh, God, I want him back! Instead of Frank, I walk into the room. Then one night they call me in about 2 a.m. And here's this 15-year-old boy who just saw his mother getting murdered by his dad. His brother got killed too, right in front of his eyes. So they bring him into the station and call me in. I see him through the window sitting there with his hands all bloody from trying to help his mother and brother. And the detective tells me, the first thing you've got to do is keep him from washing his hands. We've got to do a gunshot residue test. Would you try to explain that to him and get him to cooperate with us? And then would you get him to talk to us too? I seem to develop some kind of specialty about death notifications. One of the dispatchers started calling me the buzzard. You see, cops indulge in a morbid humor to help them cope with tragedies. So that became my nickname, the Buzzard. In fact, at the holiday awards banquet, they gave me this silly plaque. It had the cartoon of a large bird and said, if it's a coroner's case, send for the buzzard. How did I become a specialist in doing death notifications? Because I know that Jesus conquered death. And he reigns in glory in heaven's sanctuary. And that's where he helps us from in our times of desperation. The sanctuary is a theme that runs throughout this book. There are about 20 stories in about 12 chapters of bank robberies, suicides, murders, fatal accidents. All of these real-life stories illustrate some aspect of heaven's sanctuary. The here and now Jesus, who ever lives to intercede for us. And if we can call upon the police for help in emergency situations, certainly God can send help for us from his sanctuary for any of life's problems. That's what this book, God Was There, is all about. Rule number one for a chaplain is never interfere with what an officer is doing. especially in arrest. You never do that. But one time I did. And that also turned out to be a story about the sanctuary in this book. Once on a ride-along, I was chatting with the officer, and dispatch interrupted with a chilling message. A little girl was being kidnapped outside a Mexican restaurant. So we hurried over there. Some citizen hero had solved the situation, grabbing the bad guy. The first unit that arrived put him in handcuffs. By the time we got there, the little girl was safely in her mother's arms. And that sums up my vision for this book, God Was There. All of us are kidnapped victims. The devil tried to take us away from God, but Jesus rescued us. And now we're safely in God's arms in heaven's sanctuary. And my friend, whatever you're going through, it's going to be okay. God is with us. He's there for us. Jesus is our priest, our friend, and our brother in heaven's sanctuary.